भगवान राम रीच श्रृंगवेरपुर राम विग्रहवान धर्म भगवान राम इज मैनिफेस्टेशन ऑफ धर्म हिमसेल्फ. धर्म इज दैट विच इज समटाइम्स डिफिकल्ट टू फॉलो बट द फ्रूट ऑफ दैट विच इज ऑलवेज स्वीटर. Sometimes what is easy to do is difficult in the long run. Something we are suffering because we went for something easy. We suffer from that which is something easy to do in the beginning. Bhagavan Ram mind was unruffled and he reached Shringaberpur. From people who loved him, from the people who wanted to be with him, and there it is written, as he reached Shringaberpur, he saw Ganges, Uttare Ram Devasari Dekhi Keen Dandavat Harashupiseshi. Bhagavan Ram offered Dandavat Pranam to Gangaji and everybody offered Pranam. Dekho, it is written here. It is written here, Ganga Sakal Mud Mangala Mula Sab Sukh Karani Harani Sab Sula. Bhagavan Ram was coming from such a sad environment. And after coming from such a sad environment, Bhagavan Ram was very happy to see Ganges. When a person is having less ego, he is able to drop the thought faster. Bhagavan Ram dropped the thought of Ayodhya and he was more overwhelmed by the faith that he had on the Ganges. Mind should be fresh. Freshness of mind is beauty, and freshness is there when I am not holding on to something small in my mind. All sorrows come because something small I am holding on to. So he took bath in the Ganges. Majjanu keen pant ashram gayau Suchi jalu piyat mudit man bhayahu. It is very easy to be sad. But I'll tell you one thing. There are more causes to be happy than to be sad. I am not saying there is no cause to be sad. I am saying that there are causes to be happier. There are more causes to be happy. Bhagavan Ram was asked to go from the kingdom, but because he had no sense of joy, he had no sense of joy in the kingdom, therefore he was happy in the forest, in the Ganges also. The beauty of life is finding out some cause of happiness in the most disturbing situation also. And here he told the Mahima of Gangaji. He smiled, he laughed. He told Lakshmanji and Sitaji that this Gangaji had been from the toe of Bhagwan Vishnu. And then Bhagirath did the... Bhagirath was the ancestor of Bhagwan Ram. He did the penance and brought Ganges. And ultimately, this Ganges is flowing. And today also the Ganges flows in India. He was very, very happy. He was very, very quiet. As if Bhagwan Ram was as if he was not knowing it. But he was very innocent. And when, you know, there are, we get very upset with the small causes because we have lot of desires. When desire is less, joy is more. And desire which is unfulfillable desire, that is more than fulfillable desire. When a person has less desires, have desire which can be fulfilled, have desire of taking Lord's name, which can be fulfilled, have desire of doing puja, which can be fulfilled, have desire of being under the grace of Lord, which can be fulfilled. Why have those desires which is very difficult to fulfill? Here, you know, sometimes sit in your room quietly and call Bhagwan in your mind. Close your eyes sometimes and come, say, Bhagwan, please come, I want to see your feet. You will feel Lord comes after you call him. This desire can be fulfilled. Sometimes think that you are washing the feet of Lord. This desire can be fulfilled. We try to be chasing that desire which cannot be fulfilled, and then we suffer after that. Anyway, so Bhagwan Ram went forward, and then, you know, he went into Shringvirpur. Nishad Raj was the chief of the boatsmen, and there he came. Mudit liye priya bandhu bulai. He was very happy. He came along with his friends and relatives, and didn't come empty-handed, because to the king one should not go empty-handed. So he had some fruits, he had some roots, and kari dandavat bheti dharyage prabhu bilokat ati anurage. He offered dandvat pranam to Bhagwan Ram. What a moment will be there. Bhagwan Ram was standing, and Bhagwan Ram, as I told you, took his hand and asked him to sit close. Sahaj saneha bibas raghurai पूछे कुसल निकट बैठाई नाथ कुसल पद पंकज देखे भयो भाग भाजन जन लेके. He said, are you fine? Bhagwan Ram, if he talked as if everything was good and fine, so he is asking, are you fine? And Nishadara said, yes, seeing your lotus feet, who will not be fine? I have become the abode of all fortunes now. And then, as I told you yesterday, he called all his children and he called his wife and he said, I am yours along with this family, although I am very niche, I am very downtrodden, but even though I am downtrodden, I am yours only. And I have one request. Bhagavan Ram said, what is the request? Kripa kariye puradhariye pau. Please come and put your feet in my city. Thapiye jano. Please increase the... Thapiye means pratishtha. To increase the status. I'm with your presence, my status will increase. Sab log sihau. Everybody will praise me. And Bhagavan Ram said, good. Kahu satya sab sakha sujana mohi din pituaya suana. You are right, but I have been given the exile. I stay in the forest, not in the city. I can't go in the city for 14 years. Because Bhagavan Ram was very firm. He was soft but firm. People are hard and stubborn. and Bhagavan Ram was very soft but still firm. Firmness is required where one has lot of vasanas. And if vasanas are there and you know something is wrong, to stop yourself from that direction, that which I will not do that which is wrong, there you need to be firm. And therefore, one who has more vasanas, he will have less firmness. One who has lesser vasanas, he will have more firmness. So Bhagavan Ram, life requires a lot of firmness. If a person is not firm, he will do many mistakes in his life. Because various things we want to do and we don't do. Why? Because we don't have that firmness. And various things we do which we don't want to do. Why? Because I am not determined. That which gives us the capacity to be firm and determined, that is called dharma in our life. And anywhere you must have found that wherever you are not firm, there only you lost a lot. I have to do various things, my intellect says, this is wrong. The body, the sense organ, the mind, all have to say, this is wrong, I will not do that. Something, what is wrong sometimes appears very attractive. So one has to be little firm in his life. I will not be angry, one has to be very firm. Only but I feel like, you feel, then just jump in the water. Tank is there, jump. Otherwise, jump in Amgini River. But don't be angry. Why you are getting angry then? Any bigger is the dharma of a person, more firm he has to be there. There is no option that he cannot be firm. And Bhagavan Ram's one character is there, that he is very polite, very humble, very pleasant, very charming, very beautiful, very attractive, but very firm. That means he follows his dharma. And to do anything you have to be firm. To do anything big you have to be firm. You have to do regular puja, paath, jap, you have to be firm. You are attend satsang regularly, you have to be firm. You think I will be happy, you have to be firm about that. You will feel I will not leave my guru or God, you have to be firm. And these people alone can go higher in life, those who are firm. Those who are not firm, those Gurudev used to say, these chicken-hearted people. This plastic spine. These spineless people, they can't do anything. One day they will do something, 5 days they will be having gap. One day they did puja, 5 days gap. One day they did jab, then next jab will be next year. So this kind of personality, where a person is not adhering to some principle, then this person doesn't have value.
person has a value because he does something big every day for some time. Bhagavan Ram could have said, okay, for 10 minutes I'll go. But he said, nothing doing. I'm not doing anything. Being emotion, one who has emotions, one should have lot of emotion. But emotion should not erode my capacity to do right. Emotion should not be the wave which can throw away my capacity to do right. But Bhagavan Ram, in his emotion, he never does something wrong. He has so much of emotion that he will cry for Jatayu, the vulture. He has so much of emotion that he will embrace Bharatji for a long time. His emotional personality is very developed. And the charm of a person is because his emotional personality is developed. But his emotions are never able to overpower his right thing to do. And we have neither emotional personality, but still we do wrong. So here it is said here. Here said, Bhagavan Ram said, you are right. Nishad Raj, you are right. Barash chari das vasubana muni brat beshu ahar gram vas nahi uchit suni guhai bhayo dukh bhar. And he said, no, I cannot go because my father. He had a way to say also no. After that, everybody was very happy and sad also to see him. So there is one sinsupa. Night came. So night came. So how will they sleep now? So what to do? Bhagavan Ram said, I will sleep on the floor. So, but before that, it is written here, Purjan Kari Joharu Ghar Aaye Raghubar Sandhya Karan Siddhaye Guhasavari Sathari Dasai Kusakisalai Mai Mrudul Suhai Suchiphal Mool Madhur Mrudu Jani Dona Bhari Bhari Rakhe Sipani. It is said here, at that time, he said, this is where you have to stay. And Bhagavan Ram went for Sandhya Vandan. One should not leave his daily puja, paath, jap, etc. Dekho likha hai. Raghubar Sandhya Karan Siddhaya. That means he used to do evening Sandhya also. Morning Sandhya also, evening Sandhya also. Only what is Sandhya? Ab, don't ask also. So, okay, I will only say, at least do your regular puja. What you do, your jap, don't miss. Even if you have taken a vow or one mala, at least complete that one mala. And then, you know, he was about to take rest and sleep. And these people brought in their dona, the cup, leaf cup. They brought some fruit, jamun, some apple or jamun. I don't know what was there. It is not written, but it was very sweet. This much is there. This, fruit has to be sweet. Otherwise, what is the purpose? Fruit is not sweet. What is the purpose? Once what kiwi fruit is there. It's very sour. So, I asked someone that you can't have a sweet. He said, no, it is by nature sour. It can't. So you can't have sweet one. Okay, you can have. Acha, so let me have. So here, suchi, no, don't worry. Don't worry, I hardly take any fruit nowadays. Suchi phala mool, madhur mrudu vani, dona bhari bhari rakhe si pani. Pani also was in the cup, not that steel glass was there. The water was also in the cup of the leaf. Then at that time, you know what happened? The mat was put for Bhagavan Ram. Batao, aisa din aa jata hai. What day comes, we don't know. One day he was sleeping in the foam, and today he is sleeping on the floor. Si sumantra bhrata sahita
Kand mool phal khai, sahin keen Raghubansh mani.
He lied down with the same joy as if he was lying on a nice bestial bed.
Life is full of pairs of opposite.
One day, in one night, everything changes sometimes. So don't expect everything will be the same. It changes, it drastically changes. No, but when people compare, there was a good time I had. Everybody, then good time was there. Enjoy this also.
Oh yeah, there was a time, you know, I used to eat 10 puri, Swamiji. 10, 12, minimum. 12, 13. What happened? Now I can't take one also.
Why?
Cholesterol problem is there. I was eating so much of sweets once upon a time. Now I can't take any sweet. What kind of days have come now? What kind of night and days have come? I used to run like this. Now to go from bedroom to bathroom, it is a project. I avoid as much as possible that I should not go, but still, because the knees are paining, getting up is a problem. Are bata rahe, these things happen, your days changes sometime. Days changes drastically. At that time, tell to Lord, Lord, you had given me such a wonderful days. These days also I welcome it. CSU mantra prata sahit Bhagwan Ram ate.
Not that he said, I remember the nice food. He ate the fruits also with lot of joy. One thing is I have seen, Bhagwan Ram's joy doesn't go anywhere. Whether he is here, there, he does this, he does that. His personality is such that he is full of glee and joy all the time. And you know why joy goes? Because we miss something a lot. Because we are attached somewhere a lot. Because we have doubt on God. Because we are not appreciating what is God has given me. Because we are not grateful.
And at that time, Bhagwan Ram slept. Slept means he lied down. Tell me what happened after that. Sayana keen Raghubans mani paya palo tat bhai. Bhagwan Ram was there. Lakshman ji came at the feet of Bhagwan Ram. And you know what he did? He stood like that. And he put his feet on his lap. And he started pressing the feet. Is there a younger brother like this now also?
Koi aisa to nahi tha ki Bhagwan Ram father the. He was the younger, the elder brother only.
And he started pressing the feet, Lakshmanji. And ultimately, you know how long he pressed? When he saw, he was in pressing the feet, one has to see eyes of the whom you are pressing the feet. And when he saw that Bhagwan Ram's eyes was closed and he was sleeping, then slowly he did his hands like that. And after that, he left. And you know what he did? What he did? He stood somewhere with his bow and arrow and started guarding. They say, for 14 years, Lakshmanji didn't sleep. His love for Bhagwan Ram was so much that he didn't sleep. And his only work was to serve him day and night. The Nishad Raj also didn't sleep. Bhagwan Nishad Raj saw Bhagwan Ram was using his hand as a pillow and Sita Ji was also using her hand as a pillow and they were sleeping like this under a tree. And at that time, when they saw, Nishad Raj got very sad. He started crying. He said, "Who has such a palace? Whose father's throne is shared by Indra? He is sleeping like this. Dik dik fai upon ke gai, fai upon ke gai. And jogvahi jenahi pran ki nahi, mahi sovatte Ram Gosai." He is sleeping like that. That is very bad. It is unfair. And after that, Lakshman ji told some, "Dekho, these days also come. If we were there, we would be so devastated. If we were there in front of Bhagwan Ram and we had to sleep, we'll feel I'm so unfortunate. I am so, you know, I didn't get this." Bhagwan Ram's life is complaintless life, sadless life. Such a beauty is there. I'm telling you, you know what spirituality does to a person. In spite of facing the situation where one should cry, if tears doesn't come, that is a spiritual life. In spite of other person would have been shattered, but still I enjoy that situation. That is the joy of spiritual life. Spiritual life is that which gives you endless smiles. Spiritual life is that which gives you ocean of joy, even when you are surrounded by fire all around. When you are surrounded by fire all around, and still you feel that I'm feeling cool still here. Tam vidya dukkha sanyog vyogam yog sangitam. The dissociation with the association of sorrow is yog. This is called the spiritual life. And at that time, Lakshman ji became the guru of Nishad Raj. And this portion is called Lakshman Gita. We will chant after 91. Let us chant third line after. Bole lakhan madhur mrudubani. Mil gaya?
Bole lakhan madhur mrudubani. Jnana vihara bhagati ras sahani. Kohu na ko sukha dukha karda. Nij krit karam bhog sab bhata. Jog viyog bhog bhala manna. विचार नहीं कीजिए रोसु काहुनी बारी न देरी मोहनी सा सब सोहनी हारा एक सपन अनेक भये जगदानिनि जानहि जोगी परमारथी प्रपंच वियोगी जानिय तबहि जीव जग सर्व विषय मोह ब्रह्म भागा तब रघुनाथ चरण अनुराना तथा भारत मन गम वचन राम पद देव राम ब्रह्म पर भगत भूमि भूसर सुर भी सुरहित लागि कृपाल करत चरित धरि मनुज तनो सुनत मिटहि जग जाल पियावर रामचंद्र की जय
पवन सुत हनुमान की जय
गुरु
उमापति महादेव की जय
When Nishad Raj saw that very sad Bhagwan Ram is sleeping, he became very sad. Anybody, we were there, we also would be feeling bad. So Lakshman ji came as a only time in Ramayana where Lakshman ji took Guru avatar. And that tells that Lakshman ji was Gyani. And Lakshman ji generally he speaks little harshly. Bole lakhan madhur mrudu bani. Very softly, very coolly he said. And what he said? Gyan birag bhagati rasasani. He said something which was full of knowledge, dispassion and devotion. And this line, please underline. This is a golden line. Kahu na ko. Bole bhai Nishad Raj, there is no one who gives joy and sorrow to anybody. Kahu na kou sukh-dukh kar data, nij krit karam bhog sabu bhrata. Your own action comes back as sukh and as dukh, you cannot look. In Mahabharata example is given, earlier days, goshala used to be there, cow sheds. 100 cows, I told you, no? 700 number cow went to graze. It will come on its own 700 peg only. Not that we forget. But cows don't forget. Similarly, whatever actions we have done, it will come to you at its respective time. Only thing is, through someone. Why to? It chooses someone. Via someone, the fruits of action come. Via someone. It chooses a medium for that. Father is there, some action somebody has done, he has done very good action. So he became a very good father. So in the Srishti, they will choose some good jeev to become son who has done good action to have a good father. And here some father is there who has done good action to get a good son. So somehow these two meet each other. And father and son both enjoy because of their action. So whole world is fixing and it is fixing. Not match fixing. It is some kind of fixing is there. Husband, wife fixing, brother fixing, father, mother fixing, child, mother fixing. Some disease has to come. There is no option. Nobody can give you what is not in your fate. Nobody can take you what is in your fate. But why? Because your actions were like that. But I have not seen. Many things you have not seen, but it still is there. What can you do? But by wanting, you don't get anything. I'll shout, you shout, you scream, jump, do anything. It won't happen at all. But I'm very sad. You be sad. Never mind. Karma doesn't see you are sad or because you are sad. There's no problem at all.
को काहु न को सुख दुख कर दाता निज कृत कर्म भोग सब भ्राता.
And therefore a very good result is that. Supposing I have troubled someone, I have done some bad actions in the past. So some bad actions that if I have done in the past, no problem. Then what happened with that bad actions? With that bad action, I did something that I have to get a bad boss. Boss who shouts, screams. You go to the boss and say, I want a raise. He said, the one who, I have already raised you. So you can't get a raise now. And there you go, and there such a boss you get. Why? Because some actions I have done in the past, so that this kind of person is there with me. Person don't come, the container of joy and sorrow comes. Same person can be a very good source, big source of joy for someone. Same person can be a big source of sorrow for someone. Bhagavan uses everybody to give various kinds of fruits of action. And you know what is a good result? If you become karmavadi, you become very happy. Why? Why? If somebody is giving me trouble, he is not responsible. If he was not there, I would have anyway got the trouble from another person. There are a lot. If this person had not come, if he is not there, he is not there. But other person would have come. Anyway, I would have got the trouble. And therefore, why should I hate anybody? Well, but he gave me trouble. But you had to get trouble. If he was not there, somebody else would be there. I have seen the best of the doctors doing mistake. And the operations are ruined. I have asked good doctors also, successful doctors also, have you failed sometimes? He said, yes, many times. Very simple thing I did mistake on. And supposing somebody does very good for you, then you will not have attachment, because if he was not there, somebody else would have done good to you. So that if this belief in this, that the karmaphal belief makes you free from thoughts of the future and you are happy, you feel okay, if it is like that, I accept it. No problem at all. If I have to get, and what disease has to come? You don't know. Whom you have to meet? You don't know. But you know, I was regularly doing exercise and all these things, and even after doing exercise also sometimes cholesterol is there. One person was there, I told you, he went to Delhi with his brother for open heart surgery. And high blood pressure, and they said, no, it's not that much of blockage is there, and you come back. So that brother said, other brother who went with his younger brother, he said, okay, I'm feeling little tired. He said, let me check your blood pressure. The blood pressure was very high of other person who was assisting. And ultimately he said, let me have your ECG check and all this. He had 99% blockage. So one whose blockage was there, he was cleared. Now, one who was clear, he had a blockage now. Really it happened. And then younger brother called the house. So people in the house, he was in Delhi. And they called the house. He said, how are you speaking? Should be in the hospital. He said, no. The sides have changed today. And that person, teetotaler he was, no smoking, military person, walking regularly, exercising, this, that, what has to come? I have seen such fat people. One person was in Bombay, very fat person, all rounder, and when he sat with me and he started eating fried chips and lot of sweets, so I must be close to 60 or so. So I said, are you fine? Everything is fine with you? He said, yes. I said, you have no weight problem and all. He said, no. He said, I said, there is no blood pressure, diabetes. You know, nowadays it is very prevalent in 60s. He said, nothing is there. No problem. I am very happy. I got jealous. I said, unnecessary, I am controlling myself. Khub badhiya, he is having his nice potato fried, deep fried chips, and here I am taking one. Kya hai bhai? And he said, it is my bhagya. He said, you are thinking I should be cautious, but it is my bhagya. I am in Air Force. I have my regular checkups once in a month. And everything is fine as long, so far, so good. What has to happen, we will see later on. So it is not necessary that this there. Who becomes the source of your... And sometimes it so happens, the one who was source of your sorrow, he became source of your joy later on. And one who was source of your joy, he becomes source of your sorrow. One who was your critic, he becomes your praise person. One was praising, he becomes your critic. You just don't know who changes what and what fruit will come at what time. That we don't know. And this is all the play of the karma. So best is, be ready. And any fruit comes from what angle, you don't know. A person who meets an accident, does he have, he thinks that I will have any kind of accident. He is happily going out, but the car skids and something happens. So many things happen in this world. Very typical fruits come. Very, very good fruit is there. Very, very worse fruit is there. Very, very good fruit is there. So here Lakshmanji says, काहु न को सुख दुख कर भ्रादाता निज कृत कर्म भोग सब भ्राता. Not everybody gets good husband. Not everybody gets good wife. Not everybody gets good brother. Not everybody gets good father. Not everybody gets good teacher. Not everybody gets good disciple. Not everybody gets good body. Not everybody gets good house, not everybody gets good car, not everybody gets good mother-in-law. Something we get here and there. Ajeev Sagar. Achha, interesting thing is that because we have a human body, so something definitely is wrong somewhere. You can't have everything. So what shall we do? Then he comes to a philosopher. So, if I am getting sorrow, please be careful. When you are sad because of someone, you will react to that person. By that reaction to that person, you will create new bad fruit. You did wrong to me, you are bad to me, I reacted, I have a bad bhav for you after that. Because I have a bad bhav for you, because of this bad bhav and bad words that I utter, or I speak bad about you to others, because of that I have another bad fruit of action. So this is a big catch-22 situation. Firstly, I got bad fruit, and from that bad fruit I created worse fruit. So supposing I have very good fruit of action, very nice person is there in my life, very good wife is there, very good wives, very serving wife is there, rare to have. Anything good is rare. Serving wife, she does not eat without me, she gives me best of the food, she talks very nicely, she has looks also are good, and she accompanies me in every part, everything is there. I get so attached to her that I will never go to any satsang. I mean, I will be so much attached that my whole spiritual progress will be stalled. And from that attachment, I will die or she will die. So one will die, another will be very sad after that. I will have lot of impression about the husband and wife. So next birth, I'll be born as a man or a woman again. If I'm a husband, I'll be born as a girl. If I'm a wife, I'll be born as a man then. So if somebody is very good, then also there is a problem. And somebody is bad, then also there is a problem. So problem is both the side. And therefore, we have to be very careful in our life. Somebody is serving a lot, giving a lot, there are high possibilities that we are going to be attached. And we will miss something bigger in life. And if somebody is not good, there is high possibility I will hate that person after that. That both ways I am caught. And all these are so flimsy and transient that it goes after some time.
Then Nishad Raj was told, is it clear? Be very careful, and no fruit is permanent. Then he talks about the mithyat of the world. You know, this whole world, he says, Jog, Biyog, all these are worth underlining, I'm not saying now. Jog, Biyog, Bhog, Bhal, Manda, Hit, Anhit, Madhyam, Brahm, Phanda, Janam, Maran. All the world,
meeting of somebody.
Acha, tell me one thing, I'll tell you. All that, the fruit of action. What is the cause of fruit of action? Karta. What is the cause of karta?
Ignorance.
So, ignorance, grandchild is the fruit of action. Because of ignorance, the fruit of action is there. That means the result of ignorance will be ignorance. Ignorance is seeing that which is not there. Therefore, fruit of action is also ignorance. Got it? Fruit of action is ignorance, because karta is because of ignorance. Son of a dream person will be in the dream only, because karta is a dream thing. And therefore, the son of karta, called fruit of action, is also a dream. And therefore, because it is a dream, therefore all the fruit of action, all is false. Bole, how did you say like that? You said meeting of somebody is also false. Vyog means dissociating is also false. Bhog mil gaya, how many people you met, how many have passed away? And some are not passed away, still they are there, but you lost interest in them. Many people are living whom you were very close once upon a time, but you have lost interest now. And those whom you are getting interested now, you are going to lose interest later on. This is the result. It's a matter of few years, you are going to lose interest. So, jog, biyog, bhog, what bhog you like after some time? All bhog appears so boring after some time. Any enjoyment appears boring. Good and bad. Somebody is my close and far away, madhyam, brahm, phanda. They are the noose of delusions. Kaun hai aap apna? Who is ours? Who is ours? Well, he is my son. My son, your son was in the last birth grandfather of Mr. such and such. Where he was there? He was in Haridwar. His name was Ram Prasad Shukla. But in this present birth, his name is Tinku. So his name was there, but he in the last birth, he was the grandfather. His name was Ram Prasad Shukla. He died of a cancer in the age of 82.
Achha?
Haan. And where in Haridwar? Haridwar and Harkipaudi, you know. So I know Harkipaudi. This near Harkipaudi, there is a street goes there. Still you can see PC Shukla, one board is there. Ram Prasad Shukla, still they have not removed his board. Still that board is still there. And he's playing here. He is playing here. Mickey Mouse is seeing now. And he got the seat today, he got the video of Tom and Jerry also. So he is like that now. But he used to read Ramayana. Because he used to read Ramayana, therefore he has interest in Ramayana. Therefore he listens to Ramayana for some time. How long he will be living in this world? His age this time is 67 years only. He will be here till 25 years, he will be in Delhi. After 25 years, he will go to Bombay for 7 years. He will get married at the age of 32. His wife's name will be Shakuntala. And she is in Bangalore right now. She is not yet born, because she will be born in the next 2 years. And she will be there. Achha. And then when she will be, they will meet in a restaurant there. Which restaurant? They will meet in some restaurant is there in Bombay, near Kalaba. And and there they will meet there, and there they will be going there. At the age of 40, he will go to US. He will try. He will go there for 12 years, and after that he'll return back again. He will go to Delhi there. He will meet a severe accident where both legs will be broken. And because in the last year he was a policeman, he broke many people's legs. Therefore, therefore he will be there. And and both the legs will be broken. The car will ram on him. And at the age of 50, his son will get a national scholarship. And this at the age of 61, 62, he will be bedridden. But he will have lot of money and lot of respect and very good wife and children, but always have health problem. And at the age of 60, 67, he will be on dialysis. And he will pass away. He will have a quiet death. This is, but right now Tom and Jerry. This is how it's there. After that he'll go. What is the next birth? Next birth he'll be born somewhere in America. He'll be born in America. Because it was his lot of desire to be there. He couldn't work. He had to return back because of Trump. And there he will come back. And there he will be. He will be here now. So what happened to this present wife? His present wife will go. And then this present wife is going to become the son next birth. Where this son? What about his father? His father was very spiritual. So he went to Golok. He used to go to ISKCON. And now, so because of that, his father has gone to Golok there. And where the mother has gone? Mother has born into Chennai. Chennai, she has gone in a Tamil house. She always liked to cook, you know, Tamil food. Although she was a North Indian, but she always liked the Tamil food. So she will be born in Krishna Nayyar, she will be born. So she is Brahmin, Ayyar Brahmin house, and there she will be there. What her name? Her name is Sundari. Sundari Amman, so that is her name there. So who is whose son, who is whose daughter, who is whose father, who is whose mother, who is whose, what is all this going on?
Jog biyog भोग भल मंदा हित निहित मध्यम ब्रह्म पंदा जन्म मरण जन लगी जग जानू संपत्ति विपत्ति कर्म रुकालू
संपत्ति विपत्ति आया बिकॉज ऑल आर द फ्रूट ऑफ एक्शन. फ्रूट ऑफ एक्शन इज दैट टोल्ड यू ग्रैंड चाइल्ड ऑफ द इग्नोरेंस. Thus the grandchild of the dream son will be in the dream only. So this is also one dream. Dream will be broken. Then what is important about that?
Dharani dham dhanu pur parivaru sarag narak jahan lagi babha
dekhiye suniye guniye man mahi moh mool parmarat nahi. They are all full of delusion only. Who is saying? Lakshman ji is saying. Oh, it's no reality. So kale satyavad bhati prabodhe sati asadmavet. As if everything is very real. Acha, I ask you. Supposing you are 30-year-old. And I ask you, your 30 years of life, what you will say? It all passed like a dream, you know. Now is it not that 30 of years has unreal now to you? When the situations pass away, then it went like a dream. It was like a big dream. Childhood, we used to play, we used to go around, we used to dance. That day, sare wo sab pata nahi kahan. There's no reality here. This body, these relations, this mother, father, children, husband, wife.
Sapne hum bhukhari nrip rank nakpati hoy. As in the dream, the bhikhari nrip, that beggar becomes a king, and the king becomes a beggar. When he gets up, there is no gain and loss. Similarly, timi prapanch jiye joy. Similarly, one should see the prapanch also. Here also, there is no reality is there. No reality, no reality. As bichar nahi kijiye rosu. Therefore, he says,
who says? Lakshmanji says to Nishadraj,
don't get angry. Don't get angry on Kekai, etc. Don't give any fault. Nobody is any fault. Everybody is awake in this night of delusion. Mo nisasav so nihara. Dekhiye sapana. These are golden word. I quote many times. Dekhiye sapana anek prakara. This is not a dream. This is my body.
Nice body is there, you know. Nice body is there. Nice body is there. I have put gel now. Nice body is there, nice shirt is there, nice tie is there.
You know, by dressing people make their faces also. And when they see their face in them, then also they make faces. And seeing the face, it is very difficult not to touch the hair. Definitely you will touch hairs. Even if you have no hair, still you touch the hair. There is a joy of touching a bald head also. Ye hamra hai. My son is there, my son. Swamiji, my son is there. He's studying in bachelor's. He's doing bachelor's in engineering. In DUT. Oh. What engineering? Chemical engineering. Okay. This is my second daughter. How many daughters you have? No daughter. One daughter. Then how did you second daughter? I mean second. Second in after son, this is. Okay. She's younger.
Okay, okay.
Very, I am very fortunate, father.
Very nice son, daughter, God has given me. Oh, okay, thank you. Very nice thing.
Very nice house. Very comfortable house. Only wife is suffering from a diabetes nowadays.
Severe diabetes.
Achha, it was severe, yes. It has gone over 20.
Oh, 20. 20 is too much.
Okay, okay. I am here. Pray. Please pray for her. I'm a very attached person. This is my weakness. My family is my weakness. Okay.
All are delusory. Neither there is no anybody's wife, neither anybody is anybody's son, neither anybody is anybody's husband, neither anybody is anybody's. This body doesn't belong to me. This body itself is such a, as long as it is moving and I am thinking it is mine and I am thinking it is I. It is moving, it is talking, it is walking, it is thinking. You don't know when it collapses. And what you say this person was there, it becomes a dead body. And all our bodies, one day it will be called dead body. What you call I will be called dead body one day. And people will come to see us. See us means this body, and after that they'll take bath also. And I will be put on the floor. Don't talk all these things, Samji. and none of us will be there. Closest person to you will have, you will have no relation, you will not know where he is. Closest person, you will not know where he is and she is. But right now I am very infatuated. I am lost in a dream. My house, my son, my children, my capital, my this, my this. My sorrows, my biggest joy, my biggest gain. My house is this. जीवन आनी जानी छाया झूठी माया झूठी काया फिर काहे को सारी उमरिया फिर काहे को सारी उमरिया पाप की गठरी ढोई सुख के सब साथी दुख में न को मेरे राम तेरा नाम एक साचा दूजा न को ना कुछ मेरा ना कुछ तेरा ये जग जोगी वाला फेरा ये है अपना हार और अलग है एवरीथिंग अपीयरिंग वेरी रियल टू अरे रियल इज देयर देखिए सपना अनेक प्रकार वेरियस ड्रीम्स आर एवरी एक्सपीरियंस इज लाइक अ ड्रीम बिकॉज इट विल नॉट बी देयर इट वोंट बी देयर देयर इज नो रियलिटी इन इट But I see as a reality, like the dream, I see the whole dream as a reality. And who is the one who we awake in this?
Ehi jag jamini jagahi jogi paramarathi prapancha vyaha.
Wow, this is our goal.
In this night, jagi jogi, the yogi is awake. Who is that?
He is prapancha yogi.
How do you know that somebody is awake?
जानिए तब ही जीव जग जागा जब सब विषय बिलास बिरागा
He has dispassion from everything. He has dispassion from everything. He has no attachment. When a sadhu is there, na? Somebody says, yo, Sadhu Baba, this is your ashram, he smiles internally. Well, Sadhu Baba, he is your disciple, he smiles internally because he knows that this won't be there. We should live in a light, proper light. More the light is in the life, lesser is the sorrow in the life.
And what will he want?
What will he want?
What this sadhu will want after that? With whom he has to live? With what will make him unhappy if he has no desire for anything?
Well, I'll take away this thing from you. You better you take away.
We don't understand that when this person sees everything as a dream, then there is no source of sorrow in his life. Eknathji's house, in the night he was doing bhajan, I told no, thieves came. He said, don't worry, this is where the ornament is there, take everything and go in the morning. Night you will be caught. They became his devotee.
Yeah.
He is living in his own enlightened world. Well, go away from here. He said, okay. You don't live here. Well, okay. Anybody comes, he said, you know, I won't talk to you. He said, okay. I have no expectation that you should talk to me.
देखो इसी को बोलते हैं
जब सब विषय
विलास विरागा he has no attachment. Let the things happen, let the things don't happen.
One person was there, he lived with Uriya Baba for 30 years. One day he got upset with somebody in the ashram. He came, he said, Baba, I want to go and leave the ashram. Baba said, Beta, I never have stopped you. Such discretion. You can go. Who has stopped you? Hold someone, cry for someone, push someone, pull someone. These are all the sad. Tell the person doesn't have, you know, more a person has sorrow, more he is lacking dispassion in his life. And then this line is very good. Hoi hoi vivek moho brahm bhaga tab raghunath charan anuraga. When Bhagwan's feet we will be, when Bhagwan's feet we will be attached to. That day will come when I will also sing the song of Bhagwan and my heart will melt. Shri Ram Chandra Kripalu Bhajumana Haran Bhav Bhayadarunam Navakanjalochan Kanjamukhakar Kanja Pad Kanjarunam. He is intoxicated. He is intoxicated with Bhagwan. If anything is the source of joy and sorrow for an enlightened person, it is God only. Nothing can make it like that. He is emotional about it. When he thinks, "Arey, Bhagwan Ram must be lying down like this with his hand under his head. He'll be lying down. And Sita ji will be also lying down like that. And that too on the mat. And that too under a tree. Being a princess. Ah ha ha. The pyare pyare Ram." Or Lakshman ji is constantly guarding like that. And every day, every night, promptness is so much. Bhagwan Ram didn't have to ask water once from Lakshman ji. Anytime he needed, water was before and he said, Bhaiya, water. Bhaiya, fruit. Bhaiya, this path has a lot of thorns. Shall I go ahead? He said, Lakshman, but you will get the thorns. He said, no, I will clear it. Lakshman ji used to see the Sita ji. Lakshman ji is running somewhere, his thorn is pricking. He said, Bhaiya, come this way. Bhaiya, this is a bridge here.
Hold my hand, Bhaiya.
Again sitting somewhere with his clothes, wiping the stone. Le Bhaiya, please sit here. Like in Ramayana it is written, like a sansari person serves his body, Lakshman ji was serving Bhagwan Ram.
Morning to from evening, morning only we have our bath, eating, drinking, this, that. And in the night, when Ram ji used to say, Lakshman, go and sleep. He said, Bhaiya, how can I sleep unless you have slept?
And moment Bhagwan Ram got up, he saw Lakshman ji standing here in front of him with the water to wash his face. Quiet. Tuned. No other questions, no other desire.
Saints revel in this. You know what is the dream of a saint? I don't want anything. I don't want to go anywhere. I just want to tell about your katha, hear about your katha. And like my life should pass like that.
One satsang is there. One Ramayana is there, one Bhagavad is there. That's it, that is my diet. Oh Bhagwan, give me food. Don't give me food in plates, give me food in my palms. Give me plain food, give me one chapati with a small little salt also. Give me a bare floor to sleep. But give me your memory, give me your love, nothing else I want. This is called that person who has dispassion and who has love for Lord is immortal.